Good evening. On behalf of Musique Royale, welcome to tonight's virtual concert featuring Blackwood performing at St. John's Anglican Church in Lunenburg. Jeff Reilly and Peter Anthony Togni will be sharing original compositions that are actually on a new album scheduled for release in the new year. And the sources of inspiration for this music include the power of dreams, birth of children and grandchildren, the natural world, and Irish mystical poetry. The pair have been performing together in many different contexts for over two decades. They communicate in a very original language, and much of what they do is in the moment. Let me know what you think, and I hope you enjoy.
Thank you. It's wonderful to be here. It's wonderful to be here in St. John's. It's wonderful to be here in Lunenburg. And it's wonderful to be able to play again. For Peter and I, the last time we played a formal concert was in January with Barry Guy and Maya Hamburger at the Open Waters Festival in Halifax. And we had many concerts scheduled between then and now. And of course, because of COVID, we weren't able to do it. So it's a delight. And we're extremely grateful to Musique Royale and Janelle for presenting this concert. And I just want to say that as a duo, Blackwood, Peter and I have been working together so long that it's almost seems like I don't think I would know what my life would be without Peter, certainly musically and personally. So it's wonderful to just to be here and to perform again. That piece you just heard was written by Peter Anthony Togni, and it will not be on our album because it actually has already appeared on two different albums. In fact, three. It appeared in a choral version with the Almarizer Singers and also in a choral version with Luminous Voices, and it was also on one of the Sanctuary Trio CDs. So it's been well recorded, so we didn't include it on the CD, but we still love to play the piece, and it's the central movement of a five-movement work called The Lamentations of Jeremiah. This next piece is entitled Lost and Found, and it was written by yours truly. And it was written while staying in Banff, where Peter and I were our faculty in residence at the Banff Center, teaching other independent study musicians. And we had some time on our hands also, so we did a bit of writing, and this piece came out. I was blessed at the time. My twin daughters, Katie and Devin, were both at Banff at that time as well. It was just pure coincidence, not by design, doing their own programs there. And I had spent quite a bit of time with my daughters, which I sometimes spend a lot of time with, and sometimes I find now that they're in their mid-20s, they're off doing their own things. So I was sort of thinking about that. I was thinking, well, how blessed I was to have my daughters around while I was doing this time in Banff, and thinking how, you know, you're with them and you find them and then you lose them and then you find them and then you lose them, and sort of this tug and pull of the love that you feel coming and going. So I entitled this piece Lost and Found, and you'll find moments where the piece has great, it feels very tense and kind of slightly lost. That's the lost part. And you'll feel other moments where this beautiful, sweet melody comes in, and that's, of course, the found parts in it. The piece switches between lost and found.
Thank you. was lost for a bit, but now I'm found. Just love playing that one. Mr. Reilly.
Thank you, Mr. T.
The next, we're going to play two tunes of mine. The first one is called Uncountable, and it started out as thinking about a drive across Saskatchewan, and there were some lovely little flowers. I don't know what they were called, but they were very small, and they were purple, and there were millions of them, and they were, I would say, uncountable. And on another level, it's sort of like thinking of, if you will, eternity in reverse. So the closest thing to that is, I guess, uncountable. Yes, and after that, we'll do another tune of mine called Passages, and I think you'll get it when you hear it.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. So that last piece was Passages, and as Peter said, that was his piece that we kind of co-wrote, I guess, in a sense.
Yeah, yeah.
Peter came up with that beautiful accompaniment line or the chordal line, and then I improvised that melody over top of it, and we said, well, that's a pretty good melody. Let's turn that into the actual melody. The rest is history. So we're going to continue on with this program. So this next piece is entitled To Dream of Silence, To Dream of Silence. And Peter and I worked very closely on an album that I released a couple of years ago of the same title called To Dream of Silence. And it chronicled with a narrator a series of dreams I had in the early 2010s. And it was a very transformational period of my life personally, but it was also a time where my dreams seemed to have extraordinary resonance. So I kept a dream diary and then wrote this suite of pieces based on these dreams. And the first movement of the suite, the To Dream of Silence suite, is called To Dream of Silence. And it chronicles a dream I had of literally of just vast open space, just infinite space. And it was almost like I was dreaming of silence, which not the silence of nothingness, but the silence that is pregnant with the force of the universe. And this seemed to somehow reflect it. And then immediate after To Dream of Silence, I'm going to go back to a piece that I also wrote in Banff, and you'll hear that the melody, the absolutely transcendent, I hope you think it's transcendent, I don't know, maybe it's not, but I like it. It's the melody, very slow and very spacious in To Dream of Silence, becomes a very similar melody, fast and furious and quite intense, in a piece called Suddenly Snow, which is also written in Banff when I had to drive through a massive snowstorm to get from a concert I played in Calgary back to Banff and almost died about 400 times. And it was a very intense experience, but it was like I woke up in the morning and suddenly in October there was a massive snowstorm in Calgary. So out here on the East Coast is not the only place where we get crazy weather. Mm-hmm. So To Dream of Silence, straight into Suddenly Snow. This next piece, which is our penultimate performance piece, is has an interesting history in its creation, because in essence, this piece, the history of this piece goes back well over 1,000 years, probably around the year 800, and which is when the Gregorian chant, or the plain song chant, that this entire work was based on, was first created. And then from there we jump ahead about 500 years to the life of William de Machaut, who was a very, very early Renaissance, late medieval composer based in Reims in France, who was a true maverick musician, because he was one of the very first musicians to even get an inkling of the fact that you could do something like play a melody over chords. Up to this point, everything was just interlocking melodies. And he started playing with the idea that you could have a chord and a melody on top of it, and they were separate entities, as opposed to everybody feeling like they were equal, which is a radical thought for the time, and things evolved from there. And then, but fast forward to 2014, Peter Togni wrote a piece called Responsio, which was based on, in turn, his own response to Guillaume de Machaut's mass that he wrote, called The Message of Notre Dame. And in it, the Message of Notre Dame was one of the first masses to be through composed. In other words, a Kyrie, Gloria, Sanctus, and Agnus Dei, all composed to be performed in a mass setting, which is quite also radical at the time. Anyway, back to Peter Togni in 2014. Peter then took that mass by William de Machaut that was in turn based on these Gregorian chant, and wrote his own response to that. And this is one movement of that piece that we've kind of played around with since. So it's had quite an evolution. This is called, this is the, based on the Ave Verum corpus movement of the Mass of William de Machaut, that Peter has then modified, and then that we spent some time improvising on.
Thank you.
This is a bit odd because the name of this tune is Welcome, so we're welcoming you to the end of our little set. But the name actually, I'm very blessed. I have four sons and four grandsons. And I wrote this for little Dominic Joseph Aurelian Togni. He's two now, well, two and a half, and already playing the tuba. It's amazing. So. Here it is. Welcome. And it has been lovely to be here with you and Jeff and in this gorgeous church. We always like coming here to play. Always feel so good when we come in here. And also such a lovely piano. And, thanks. And thanks, John and Glenn.
Thank you.